Guys, today for this video, in World of Warships, something appealing just came to me, my mind, the other day. So, guys, if you are actually Yamato captains, you may know that Yamato is actually one of the easiest battleships to citadel in the game. I mean, it gets citadeled so easily that even cruisers can citadel to death too, you know? I mean, we have a lot of those David and Goliath moments, you know, with tier 10 cruiser versus Yamato. Well, it actually gave me an idea. How fast can every tier 10 cruiser citadel a Yamato to death? So that's what we're going to be doing for this video. We're going to be seeing how quickly every tier 10 cruiser can citadel a Yamato to death. Well, every tier 10 cruiser I have, because I have 5 out of the 7 tier 10 cruisers. Because I do not have the Moskva nor the Zhao. I mean, I'm obviously not. I mean, of course, you know, I would never include the Salem, you know, or any other. I'm not including the Salem in this test, you know, because obviously it's just another Des Moines, you know. And I mean, of course, the Stalingrad and future tier 10 battle cruisers. I mean, of course, no way I'm including those, because you know that's just a really a show-off. That's just really a show-off, to be honest. I mean, it really wouldn't be fair, you know, because, you know, with the long reloading time, you know, when they're, you know, really powerful guns, you know, that's kind of, like, off-topic, you know. I really don't consider any tier 10 cruiser, you know, with, any tier 10, cruiser that's really a battle cruiser. I don't call it a proper tier 10 cruiser because, you know, just from my knowledge, you know. But anyway, guys, it is a little disappointing though that I actually don't have the Moskva on the Zhao yet. You know, I do have another video on mine. You know, you could just be arguing that I could have just done this, but then again, I am still aiming to put up more videos this month than for this year's December than last year. So, either way, guys. Anyway, I think that's enough chit-chatting here. Let me just reverse my Des Moines back into a position now. Now, when I actually kill off the Yamatos, I'm actually going to be making sure they're not only both broadsiding but also at a similar distance as well. And I'm also going to be aiming underneath the second turret, because I've often seen Yamatos get citadels here a lot in videos. I mean, at least from what I can remember from my experience, you know, seeing this in YouTube videos. But anyway, that's enough chit-chatting. Let's just get on with the action. Let's see how fast the Des Moines can do it. Okay, one salvo. Two. Let's go. Okay, that's number two then. Three. Four. Five. And, six. Wait, no, that's not. No, take that back. Okay, that's proper six. Now, I actually wasn't. Now, you know what? I did fire actually more than six salvos, but I actually weren't counting them as salvos, because, you know, in order to count them as salvos, you know, they have to do over 10,000 damage, which is why. So, all the salvos that did do 10,000 damage or more are counted as. Salvos. So since the Des Moines has a reload, since the Des Moines has a, okay, I need to do the math on this exactly. Right, I don't have anything to calculate with, but, I need to think about how to do the math on this, Alright, so So now I actually put the label the three salvos that failed as a complete salvo, because you know they did it at least over 10,000 damage, and Des Moines could do that much damage in one salvo to Yamato. So overall, that's so that would actually be seven salvos, and so it would take 38.5 seconds for Des Moines, you know, to sit all Yamato to death, you know, assuming you got the position right. But next up, now we have the Worcester. Now, I'm not too sure about the Worcester though. I think that since due to the low gun caliber, it might probably not be able to pierce the citadel and probably do over 10,000 damage per salvo. But it should be able to do the job very quickly, at least 4.6 seconds. I've got the angle right, so I'm just gonna count the salvos here, and also try and make sure I count the false salvos. But anyway, let's just see what happens here. Okay, that's one. Okay. Two. Worcester, that did pretty bad. Okay, I need to make time on that. I need to calculate the time here. Worcester, Worcester's, you'd be much better off using high explosive shells, you know, if you noticed your AP wouldn't work. But next up, contender, our next contender is, well, one that is certainly gonna work, the Hindenburg. I mean, I've got plenty of experience with this thing. I've had this thing for over a year. I don't remember the exact date when I got this, but I know with last year, I think it was, I don't know, for sure. But, anyway, we're just gonna pull up to. Anyway, as we wait to pull up with this Yamato. Oh, and by the way, before we actually get completely pulled up against the Yamato, since the Worcester did pretty bad, something tells me that the Minotaur probably might do just as bad, you know, with AP shells. I mean, we don't know that for sure because Minotaur. Because British AP shells are, of course, different from those from other nations, you know, since the British, cruisers don't have they actually don't have high explosive shells, you know, except for Belfast, which does have okay, let's just make sure we're at, make sure we are in range for Let's just make sure we are at a close enough range, and I think this should hopefully, okay, I think this should be good enough. Alright, here we go. 3, 2, 1, go! Okay, that's one. It's two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. And finally, I'm just gonna finish it off. Okay, that's totally eight here. Because then again, that's the saturation mechanic, you know. Okay, so yeah, it would take 88 seconds for a Hindenburg to citadel a Yamato to death. So, all right, so we got the Minotaur test ready. Certainly cannot wait to see how it goes. Alright, so now it's probably gonna go just as bad as the Wurtzinger test, but we're gonna have to see for sure. I'm actually gonna be aiming at different areas, you know, of the ship too, you know, to help, you know. Anyway, let's just get started. None. I think I hit the spot. Okay, yeah. Okay, that's two. I have three. 3.5, okay, that's eight. Nine. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, I think this was 15, and, 16, 17. Wait, no, that's not how 17. 17. 18. Alright, so finally now, we got the Island of the Force, and I think this is probably gonna do it in the fastest time. Let's just see for sure. Okay. Okay, I need to back this up in position a little bit, and we're ready to go. Ouch, there goes half of the HP pool already. That's a nice start. Now this. Ouch. Yeah, I mean, you can even do it in two salvos. You can even do this in two salvos. So, I mean, earlier on a failed attempt, you know, while trying to do this, I actually did it in I actually managed to take it down in two salvos, and if you took it down in two salvos, it would take basically 24.6 seconds. And it would take 37 seconds if it took you three salvos. So, I mean, and this is without the quick reloader thingy. Yeah, because I can't speak today. There'll be parties for hosting, marshmallows for toasting, and carrying. So, I mean, it can depend, you know, on your luck. Look, so we got that firmly established. Out of them all, you know, Omni the Fourth did the job pretty quicker. So, I look forward to how the Moskva is gonna be able to compete for that soon. I mean, depending when I get the Moskva, bless me. Okay, like. Like you can see there, I just got in two salvos. So, either way, guys. Either way, it was pretty much a lot of fun to make this video. So, I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you already did, then I hope you guys hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you already did, don't forget to press that like button and subscribe to the channel. If you're already subscribed, then don't forget to turn on the notification bell so that way you can be notified every time a new video like this is posted. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye then.